Hey, what's up YouTube? This is your girl Abie, and in today's video I will be sharing with you a free Notion template that you can use to organize your personal brand. First, what I will go over is what is Notion, because if you're watching this video, you may already know what it is, but there may be some people that don't know. And then I will share the actual brand board with you. We'll hop on my computer and I'll show you how you can use it to fit your brand and just how to make it work best for you. And I'll show you how you can download this template and use it as your own in your own Notion account. And you'll want to stick around to the end if you want to get your brand organized and learn how to use a great productivity tool that can really help you in all areas of your life. I use it for everything. In fact, I actually talked more about it in a video I did in a series where I talked about systems. So I'll link that video. It's actually the third video I give you just a peek into my systems and my Notion dashboard. So I'll share that video. You can check it out. But let's go and get into this one, and you can let me know what you think. And feel free to comment below any videos that you would want to see regarding Notion in the future. Okay, so first off, what is Notion? And like I said, I won't go too deep into it because I shared a little bit more in that other video. But Notion is pretty much, it's an all-in-one tool that a lot of people use for productivity, but it is also a really big note-taking tool. I use it to set up my systems for my business and also my personal life, but it includes things just like general notes, the wiki boards that you see like on Trello or Asana. You can incorporate a lot of different tools into Notion, and you can use it for everything. I plan my entire life and business on Notion. So if you're really into planning and organizing, this is definitely a tool that you should check out. But what I'm gonna actually share with you today is my brand board and how you can use it to organize your brand as well. So let's just go ahead and just hop into my computer so I can show it to you, and feel free to ask me any questions below.
Okay guys, so welcome to my computer, and this is the brand board. The way that I have it set up is by column. So this very first column you see start here, and then each other column is just different things about your brand or different category about your brand that you can organize here in this board. So the very first thing that I would like for you to do is to watch this video so you can kind of understand how to duplicate the board and use it, or duplicate this template and use it as your own in case you happen to get the template before watching the video. And then you go ahead and duplicate the board or the template. So you just would hit duplicate and it will take you here. And you can either continue with Google or your Apple ID or Apple email. And if you have a Notion account, you can go ahead and just log in here. Otherwise, you can just create one. So I will show you what it looks like using when I started editing. So once you do have it in your own Notion, you'll have the option to do more edits. And that's actually going into step three, which is complete each card according to your own brand. So each card, the very first card of each column is just like a title card. So I just did it this way so it's easy to see. So brand identity, if you were to click here, say you don't like the cards, the light blue and the black that I did, you can actually change the cover and you can use one of their photos, or you can upload a photo, which is what I did. Now the photo that I use is actually here. So in case you want to use it as a way to create your own as like a template, you know, you can download it, you can see the size. So, you know, I pretty much just use a square, simple, like if you're going to use an Instagram template on Canva or something, and I just centered it. But one thing you can also do is you can reposition the image. So that's just a title card. There is one thing. So here, for the brand identity column, you'll see I have like logos. I'm very visual, so I want to be able to see my brand colors, my logos, my font that I'm using. Even though this isn't exactly my brand color or my brand colors, I just wanted you to see so you can get an idea that you can make this visual if you don't want it to just be all text. So what I do have here, and I'll let you take a look at that. If you were to click on this card, it's not showing on this, but I promise it will be there when you look at it. If you were to click on this card, there is going to be a link that will take you to this Canva template. And this is just in case you want to do something like I did there. You can use Canva to, you know, create your brand colors, your fonts, you know, make it match your own brand. So you can go ahead and just do that there. Use profile pics, and So that way, if you are visual like me and you want to see the actual colors and the photos, you can use that here. So one thing here, like I have different profile pics. Like I use this one for YouTube and for my Instagram, my personal Instagram, but I also have a different profile pic that I use for my business. So you can duplicate, you can easily duplicate this and just change the photo. So you can play around with that. The social media column is pretty self-explanatory. So an easy way that I made it that you can use this is that you can use a template. So here you should, you know, want to go ahead and include all of your social media that you use. It's just a nice place to have it organized. If you were to include the template, you know, you can put your handle, the link, your login and passcode if you need somewhere to remember it. But another way that you can do it is you can go to new, let's say you're doing TikTok or something. You create a new card, but when you go in here, these are the templates I created for you. So this will be new social media. When you click on that, I'll go ahead and just pre-fill. I guess I'll just include these that I already put in here for you. So one way you can edit the templates, if you go here where it shows new, you see all of the templates here. So if you don't like how I have that, or you want to add a few more things to the template, you can just go here and go to edit social media, and you can add, you know, whatever you want to add. Let's say, I don't know, let's say colors. Not that you'd have colors for TikTok. And we'll bold that like the other one. Or maybe you want to highlight these. However you want to edit it yourself. Oops. So you can change the colors here, but I said I want to highlight that orange for some reason. It shows you here that you're editing a template. So that just edits a template. So if you come back here and you go to add a new template, and let's say this is Facebook. Not a new template, a new card. And you go to new social media, you'll see the template has been updated to now have it be orange. You can also add new cards from here. So when you click on this, it will go ahead and add it. Instead of doing it under the columns, it's up to you. So brand messaging, I know when a lot of people think of branding, they think of just colors, like your font and your logo and the colors that you want to use. But a lot of branding has to do with your messaging, so that you know that you're speaking to the right people and you're putting out the right message there for your brand. So this is just a good place that you can come and you know, organize what your message is for your brand. And I just have these prompts that you can fill out and you can put it in here. If you want to make it more visual, like how this is, you can, you know, go ahead and use the cards or add attachments there that are photos. There's a lot that you can do on Notion. So let's say here you can embed a lot of things. So if we go to the plus sign, say you already have your mission statement saved in a Google document. You can actually embed a Google document here, something from your Google Drive. There are a lot of other, I don't want to go too deep into Notion here. If you want to see more about Notion, let me know and I will go ahead and do another video. There are a lot of different things that you can embed within the card itself. So if you have an image, if you have a video, audio, even if it's something you recorded on Loom, which is what I'm doing right now, you can actually embed it in here and you can add pages inside of pages. So if you wanted to, for some reason, add a calendar in your mission statement, I'm not sure why you would do that, but you can embed a calendar in here. So there are a lot of options that you have here that you can do with every single card. So these are just prompts that you would fill out. Same thing with your ideal client avatar. And this is just who your ideal customer is. All of these things are just optional, but you do want to know who your customer is, so you know who you're talking to and who you're trying to sell. And it doesn't necessarily say you are just a, say you don't necessarily sell a product, but you are an influencer. It's still good to know who your audience is. Maybe you're an influencer and you're a mom blogger, and so your audience, you want to be moms or parents and, you know, people that are interested in mommy stuff or baby stuff. So you would want to fill out all of these things so you know you know, who your messaging is going towards. Competitor analysis, and I know when people think of competitors, it's not, you know, doesn't necessarily mean someone that is your arch nemesis or someone that you are going against. It really could just be people that are similar to, or that have similar content to you, or sell similar products, people that you may even want to collaborate with. And it's good to see what is being done, what has already been done, so you can see also how you can make your product or your content, you know, better, see what is missing, or see who you can work with. So it's good to have a competitor analysis. You know, don't skip that. But when you see that I put this here, it means that I do have a template already created for you for it. Okay, so if you were to go here and say you have a new competitor, you can just hit no, and you can put their name in here. Say you created your card for it. So here I have a template for new competitor. So when you click on that, it'll just give you kind of a prompt for some questions that you can go off of, but this is not, you know, the end all be all. You can put your own questions in there, like how I showed you how you can edit the template and make it your own. So lead magnets are just a way to get people into your community in a way. So this right here, what you're watching, is a lead magnet, and it's to really speak to the people that you are wanting to connect with or do business with or collaborate with. And it's a way to build your email list. So you can go ahead and put what your lead magnets here. I have a couple of ones here that I had done before. So you can create one here. Let's just say. And I have a template for that. And then the same thing for paid offer. If you have any paid products or paid offers, you can include that there. So I hope all of that kind of makes sense to you. Let me know if you have questions about it. But like I mentioned, you can go ahead and duplicate this board or duplicate this template and use it as your own. And going back to our steps here. So step four, I do have a free 11-page guide, and it's just about building your personal brand. So if you want to check that there, I also have a $7 ebook that's just like about personal branding as well. So it's just like building off of this, which is also a lead magnet freebie, but you don't, since you've already downloaded this, when you click on this, it'll just take you straight to the PDF. It's not something that you have to opt into again. And join my free Facebook group if you want to be a part of my community and a part of what I have going on, and just want to learn more about building your brand and also building systems and setting up systems in your business. So this group is on Facebook. So you can go ahead and join my free Facebook group if you want to be a part of that. This link will take you to it here. And then the last thing is, if you like this template, if you like this board, if you found it useful at all, please give me a thumbs up for this video here on YouTube and leave me a comment. If you are getting this board without watching the video first, you can go ahead and click on the link there and it'll take you to this video. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want to see more things like this, and let me know what you would like to see from me, what type of videos you'd like to see from me, and I will catch you next time. Bye.